Hello, and welcome to Terra Incognita. In this segment of 7-Minute Max, we're going to look at the matte shadow reflection material. We'll be using Mental Ray and 3ds Max Design 2015. We need a few basic elements in our scene to demonstrate this material. What we'll be doing today is primarily using it just to capture shadow information and to be able to use that information without the geometry. So I'm going to draw a teapot to cast some shadows, a plane to receive them, and a light in order to generate the energy for the shadows. We'll turn on exposure control, drag out our light. I'm going to change this light to a spotlight. Move it up in the scene. And let's see how that looks. All right, it's not going to be a pretty render any way we cut it, but I could see maybe a little exposure control would help there. We'll change that to about 6. I also noticed that the shadows were flowing over the edge of the plane, so let's increase that size. And we'll zoom in a little closer to the action here. A little more angle. Move it to the right of the screen so we could see more of the shadow. And render again. So this is our starting point. We have a spotlight casting a pretty strong shadow onto a plane. We haven't assigned any materials. Let's look at our alpha channel. If we need to composite this object and its shadow onto another surface, this is going to be a problem. We don't have any alpha information, and we would end up spending a lot of time in Photoshop with the lasso tool and trying to blend the edges. It just wouldn't look very good. So this is where the matte shadow material comes in. We'll pull up the material editor. I'm pressing M on the keyboard to do that. And we'll just use the compact editor for simplicity's sake. The material is under the Mental Ray rollout. And here we go, matte shadow reflection. Let's apply this material to our plane. Just out of the box, I'll go ahead and select the plane, assign the material to the selection. We see the change in the viewport, and let's see what that looks like. It's a little hard to tell if this worked or not. We could look at our alpha channel. It appears that there's still shadow information in there. Let's go ahead and save a copy. We'll call it test one. And of course, if I'm going to be using an alpha channel, I need to make sure to save the file in a format which contains an alpha channel. Here, I'll select PNG, 24-bit, and make sure that my alpha channel is enabled. Let's switch over to Photoshop. I'm going to insert the image. And here we can see that things are looking pretty good. We've brought our object in is a solid, it's occluding the background, and our shadow has some touch of transparency. It's a little harsh, pretty hard edges, but of course we haven't put any effort into softening that or making the shadow any better. I've put a wood deck material in here just to see how we might use this, and this is a good example. You might want to put your image with its shadow onto, in this case, just a different texture, but usually a image of what the real surroundings will be. So that's looking good. Let's switch back to Max and see what other features we could find in here. Well, first of all, we could change the background that's being mapped. Let's change it in this case to white. It will give us a little better idea of what we have in the render window. Notice that the background also will take an image size, as most of these will. But this will be useful when you're composing your image to put the actual surroundings behind it. Then using the matte shadow reflection material, you'll be able to extract the shadow and reflection information into the image you want to use. We noticed in the last round how harsh our shadows were. Let's use the mask opacity just to soften that a little bit. And let's punch our teapot, see how that looks. The render frame window has gotten a little more useful. We can now see the edges of our plane and have a little better idea of the shadows that we're capturing. It may make you a little nervous to actually see the edges of the plane back here, wondering if that will show up in your composition. We'll switch to the alpha channel and we could see that it does appear just to be the shadows and the object. let's save out a copy and we'll see how that looks in Photoshop. There we go. We're making some progress in terms of our shadow, at least opacity. Well, we still have a little time left. Let's switch back to Max, check out a few more features of this material. We could see in the shadows area where we can enable or disable shadows, the ambient shadow intensity will be controlled here. It relies on the ambient occlusion settings beneath. And we can mess around with the color. This checkbox is very useful, where you can select specifically which lights you want to be casting shadows onto this material. Let's come down a little further. We can see a little halo appearing on our plane here. That's the result of indirect illumination, the light bouncing off the teapot and hitting the plane. In some cases you might want that, in some it might be undesirable. You can disable the plane receiving indirect illumination with this checkbox. Take a render. And now we can see that that halo is gone. We can also work with direct illumination, similar to the lights. We could select which lights we would like to see on the plane. Finally, let's play with the reflection rollout here. Let's enable receive reflections and see what we get. Now we could see that the material is acting as many of our standard reflections material would. We're controlling the intensity of the reflection by the reflection color. Let's make it a little lower to see what effect that has. We also have a glossiness setting. We'll turn the glossiness down to 0.8. And then the samples for the quality of the reflection. Let's take one final render and see how it looks. And we could see how our changes have affected the reflection. Let's send this over to Photoshop one final time. And now we could see where our reflective material is showing up as well as our shadow material. So although our methods are crude, I'm sure you can start seeing the potential of this material for compositing shadows, reflections, and objects into other images. That's all we have time for today. Thank you for listening, and good luck with the matte shadow reflection material.